As Parliament kicked off business today, legislators piqued interest in the continuous absence and late coming of ministers, which frustrates business of the House.
The ministers just sit and agree and say that we shall not go to Parliament. It is time we took decisions that are hard. The work of the government chief whip is becoming very difficult. You find the government chief whip in the corridors, making calls, trying to tell the honorable you are supposed to be in the House. But the order paper is laid way before we start the House.
On top of whether not coming or coming late, when they appear, right on speaker, and they are done with their business, they just walk out.
The government whip, Dennis Hampson-Oboa, implored Parliament leadership to take action against those that offend Parliament's attendance rota.
This House is run by rules. This House is run by rules. I would suggest that in the circumstances, just like in the field of sports, you are given a verbal warning, you commit another foul, a yellow card, you commit the third foul, you are red carded.
Speaker Among asked the government chief whip to submit a list of ministers who snubbed today's sitting for further action. MPs explained the implication of continued absence of ministers.
Ministers who are supposed to have attended a Wednesday's sitting. I need that list.
The way we deliberate and the way we run our business in Parliament, we need the executive. And it is the ministers or the prime minister with the leader of government business, and the other side, the leader of opposition with his shadow ministers.
When ministers don't attend Parliament, it is rather a shaming, especially even to the appointing authority, because if the president appointed them to come sit in Parliament or go elsewhere and do what they're supposed to do and they don't, I think it is a shaming.
There is a problem with the ministers of Museveni's government. One, they are busy in their businesses because they are not to serve Ugandans as ministers. They are there to serve the interests of their boss.
In the same sitting, Speaker Among gave the Minister of Education and Sports up to tomorrow to table regulations on school fees, saying some school administrators are taking advantage of absence of these regulations to exploit parents and impose exorbitant charges, even in schools funded by government.
Most students cannot even go to school because of the exploitation that the schools are doing. Can we have the regulations on the floor tomorrow? Because we've been speaking about the regulations.
In support of the Speaker's directive, I think these regulations need to be laid as soon as possible because we are having very many schools, government and private, exploiting parents, exploiting many people out there.
Still, the Speaker has called for a statement from government tomorrow, explaining the new hikes in fuel prices and steps being taken by government to arrest the situation. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.